The best way to explain the new direct forms capability in Web Core version 1.9.8 is to compare the direct forms behavior with the classic or the default behavior in a Web Core application. And so to demonstrate this, let's create a new Web Core web client application. And you can see the project being created here. And this has one form, the main form, unit one. And with that form, we have an HTML file associated. Let's first save the project into a new folder so that we can see what exactly is generated. We save it into this direct forms folder. All the files are saved, and I can obviously add controls to this form, add some basic logic to the form code, like this, for example. And when we run this project, we see the expected result, the button and the edit control, and the code being executed. Now, if we open this HTML file, which is the template file for the main form for this unit one, and we add some content to this template file, it can be this very easy text, but it can be complex HTML as well. So, and we run this application. Now we see that the template file is being used and the content is also displayed here together with the controls. If we have a look at the folder, what has been created, the application itself was created in the debug folder. And so what we can see here is the main project HTML file, the project application JavaScript file, and this is the HTML file that is used for the main form. What technically actually happens is that when you start the application by opening project 1.html, the JavaScript executes and will actually instruct to load the template file for the form that is needed that will be displayed. Now, when we double click this from the Windows Explorer, we see here nothing. And when we have a closer look at the console, we see that this error appears. This means that the application was unable to load the unit one HTML file, the template file for the main form, which is normal. As I open it from Windows Explorer, there is no HTTP server, so the HTML file cannot be requested via an HTTP request that is used. When we run this same application from the IDE, it obviously works, and it works because there is a debug web server, and you can see this one here. It's installed by default with TMS Web Core. This is the debug web server. It's an HTTP server, and this HTTP server will return the unit one HTML file for the main form. Now, with direct forms, we can avoid this, and as such, in specific scenarios, make the loading of forms faster and make applications also work when we simply start them from Windows Explorer. So what we are going to do is we are going to remove this form from the project, and from the IDE repository, we are going to add here a new capability in Web Core 1.9.8, which is to add a direct form. When we add this to the project, you can see that now there is no HTML file associated with this specific form. We can obviously add again controls to the form and add some basic logic, and everything should function again. So let's add the same code and let's run this application. And obviously, what we see is what we expected. The application is running. When now from our Windows Explorer, we will open this HTML file and inspect it in the browser, you can see that this application is actually working. And so that means that Direct Forms is no longer in the console. There won't be this errors that it cannot load the template file, because there simply is no template file in this scenario. Now, where can we still customize HTML? Now we can do this in Project HTML, because there is no template for the main form. So the HTML with which the application is started, the Project 1 HTML file, is preserved, and we can as such customize its content and modify things, add things as we want. So we go to the body section of this file, and here we can add hello world from a Direct Forms app, and let's run this application. And the result is what we expect. The HTML is now coming from the Project 1 HTML file, and we can also open it directly from Windows Explorer. So everything that you could do with Web Core with normal forms and linking to HTML templates would now have to be done with linking to what you put in the project main template file, and no longer in a form specific HTML template file. You can choose what option you want. If in scenarios you want to start Web Core apps directly from Windows Explorer or another file system, that is now possible. You can use it to optimize performance. So you can choose, you can mix in your application Direct Forms with HTML template driven forms. These possibilities are available now from Web Core 1.9.8.